Okay. But he comes every 3 days. He will go, you know, 2 days he will go absent for 2, 3 days, and then he will come back again. You're the most irregular one. Two, when you walk into the class, do you care about learning? Do you realize what we are here for? Don't talk in Hindi first. Okay, never. Saddam, never engage in a Hindi conversation in the class. Like I have said, yesterday I was having this conversation with Abhinav. You guys have no idea how you learn. You have learned a little bit, but you do not know the process how you learn.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Nasheen. You learn because of one thing only, and that is the 100% English environment that we have. So do not spoil it by speaking Hindi to each other. Okay. I know when I speak English, you don't understand everything. That's okay. You're still learning because you're here to learn to speak English. You're not here to learn English only. You're here to learn to speak English. There is a big difference. Come in. In my previous class, the class before yours, I read a text to my students, an email. I talked about so many things, vocabulary, structure, formal, informal. They'll not speak English because of the knowledge I gave them. हिंदी में बोल देता हूं ताकि ये बात क्लियर हो पहले तुम्हारे दिमाग में, सब लोगों के
गुड
दिमाग
मॉर्निंग
में.
सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग फैजान. पिछले क्लास में मैंने एक ईमेल पढ़ा और उस ईमेल में बहुत सी चीजें लिखी थी, उसके बारे में बहुत सी बातें की. 90 मिनट्स मैं बोलता रहा उस क्लास में, ठीक है. वहां पर मैंने कई शब्द के बारे में बात की, कई स्ट्रक्चर्स के बारे में बात की, बहुत सी बातें की. लेकिन लोग वहां जो इंग्लिश बोलेंगे वो उस नॉलेज की वजह से नहीं बोलेंगे जो मैंने दिया. गलतफहमी है लोगों की. वो उस नॉलेज की वजह से नहीं बोलेंगे. अगर उस नॉलेज की वजह से बोलते तो वो मैं नॉलेज उनको हिंदी में और बेहतर दे सकता था, क्योंकि और ज्यादा बेहतर समझ जाते मेरी बात. नॉलेज मैं आपको किस भाषा में बेहतर दे सकता हूं, हिंदी में या इंग्लिश में?
हिंदी
क्योंकि
में
आप हिंदी को 100% समझते हो, तो आप नॉलेज से नहीं बोलोगे इंग्लिश. याद रखो बहुत क्लियरली, जिस तरह से मैं अभी बात कर रहा हूं, ये टाइम वेस्ट है आपका, क्योंकि मैं अभी कौन सी भाषा बोल रहा हूं
हिंदी
और आप पूरी तरह से मेरी बात समझ रहे हैं, हाँ या ना? फिर
यस
भी आपके लिए 100% टाइम वेस्ट है. अगर ऐसे ही मैं आपको बहुत सी चीजें पढ़ाऊं हिंदी बोल बोल के रोज इस क्लास में, आप बहुत खुश होकर यहां से जाएंगे कि सर जो भी पढ़ाते मुझे बिल्कुल समझ में आ जाता है 100%. लेकिन आपके लिए टोटल वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम है ये. किस लिहाज से? इंग्लिश बोलने के लिहाज से. इंग्लिश सीखने के लिहाज से बहुत अच्छा है, आप बहुत कुछ जान जाएंगे इंग्लिश के बारे में. जितनी बातें मैं बताऊंगा और अच्छे से जान जाएंगे, क्योंकि मैं हिंदी में बता रहा हूं, हिंदी आपकी मदर टंग है. हेलो पद्मा, आई नो पद्मा विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, शी इज फ्रॉम आंध्र प्रदेश. बाकी आप लोग समझ जाओगे हिंदी में, राइट? तो आपके लिए तो बेहतर होना चाहिए, मुझे तो हिंदी में बोलना चाहिए, क्या बेहतर समझ जाओगे, हाँ या ना? अगर मैं कोई चीज इंग्लिश में समझाऊं आपको और वही चीज मैं हिंदी में समझाऊं, आप समझेंगे बेहतर कब? बताइए, पक्का है ना? तो फिर मुझे पागल कुत्ते ने काटा है कि मैं आपको इंग्लिश बोल के समझाता हूं, जब आप बेहतर समझेंगे हिंदी में. तो इससे क्या पता चला आपको कि मेरे हिंदी में समझाने से और आपके समझ जाने से आपके इंग्लिश बोलने की क्षमता में रत्ती भर का फर्क नहीं आने वाला? और जब मैं इंग्लिश बोल के समझाता हूं तो आप क्या मेरी बात पूरी तरह से समझते हैं? नहीं समझते हैं, मुझे पक्का पता है नहीं समझते हैं. फिर भी मैं वही करता हूं, रोज करता हूं. क्यों? और सिर्फ आपके साथ नहीं कर रहा, मैंने ऐसा ही हम सबके साथ किया, राइट? और उसमें से कुछ ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स निकले जिनकी इंग्लिश बहुत अच्छी हो गई, बोलने की क्षमता. कैसे? क्योंकि मेरा समझाना मायने नहीं रखता और आपका समझना मायने नहीं रखता. आपका मेरा सुनना मायने रखता है. आप मुझे सुनते हैं, आप गौर करते हैं कि मैंने कौन से वर्ड्स रखे हैं मेरे साथ अगले वर्ड्स पे. वो उस अरेंजमेंट पे ध्यान देना आपका मायने रखता है. बस आप इंग्लिश बोलना इससे सीखते हैं. इसलिए जो आपको लगता है कि जिससे आप सीखते हैं उससे आप नहीं सीखते हैं. और जिस चीज को आप बिल्कुल वैल्यू नहीं करते हैं उससे आप 100% सीख रहे हैं. नाउ आई विल स्विच बैक टू इंग्लिश बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट टू वेस्ट एनी मोर ऑफ योर टाइम. एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट वी आर स्टडिंग. गुड मॉर्निंग आयुष. व्हाट वी आर स्टडिंग, व्हाट सब्जेक्ट, व्हाट चैप्टर वी आर स्टडिंग, व्हाट आइडिया, व्हाट स्ट्रक्चर वी आर स्टडिंग इज ऑल इरेलेवेंट. व्हाट इज रेलेवेंट इज यू पे अटेंशन टू व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. That's all. Try and understand my words, how I'm putting the words together. Of course, you will not understand me 100%. I'm aware of it. A lot of 99% or 90% of my students will not understand me 100%. They will understand some things of what I'm saying. But just grab those some things and be happy. Next day you will be better. You won't realize it, but next day you will be better. Next day you'll be better. And a time will come, you will be much better than what you are today. So this process is a very unique process and you guys have no idea about it, how this works. There is a reason, again I will say, okay, why the students who stay in this course, okay, eventually learn to speak English. Because I have decoded this important thing. Suppose I sit down here and I tell you a story of my girlfriend and me when we were young, you know, and what things, stupid things we did together. Of course, it has nothing to do with the studies. It is a personal life story, but it will have the same impact on your English learning. You will learn to speak English better because of that story. If you pay attention to what I'm saying. If I tell you about a scientific experiment somewhere, okay? And if you pay attention, you will still improve your English. So you will only improve your speaking English by paying attention to the teacher, to the audio files, to the recording. That's it. Means you have to rely only on your ears. 90% your learning will be because of your ears. So make your ears work. Your eyes are not going to help you much in this course. 10%. 90% responsibility is on your ears. Got it? Your mouth has no role to learn English. People are wrong when they tell you that you need to speak English to learn English. That's what I said. The reality of the matter is something that even teachers are not aware of. Learning takes in two situations. When you are listening and when you are reading. When you are speaking and when you are writing, you are not learning. You are showing what you have learned. Please, Faraz, come in. When you speak, you learn zero in that moment. You show what you have learned. So your tongue plays no role in learning. You guys have been told, speak English if you want to speak English. People, there was this lovely video, 3-4 friends were sitting together and they said, from today we will speak English. He said, yes, we will talk in English. And then they, all of them are quiet, right? Because they can say nothing in English. So that's a good joke and a good sarcasm on the ignorance of people. If you want to learn to speak English, you don't speak English. You listen to English. It has an impact on you. And then you automatically speak English. If you want to speak Punjabi today, what will you do? Suppose you want to speak, you want to learn to speak Punjabi. What will you do? You'll start speaking Punjabi. Come on, guys, let's talk in Punjabi. Tusi kithe ja rahe ho? All right, I said one sentence in Punjabi. Oh, and after that? So this was a stupid comment that speak if you want to learn to speak. Good advice is listen if you want to speak. If you want to learn to speak Punjabi, what will you do? Come on, let's talk in Punjabi, guys. Let's talk in Punjabi. If I play Punjabi conversations every day in front of you, okay? Punjabi conversation. Two people are having Punjabi conversation with each other. And we listen to them every day for 3 months. Tell me, are we in a better position after 3 months to make Punjabi sentences? Yes or no? What did we do for 3 months? We listened. So have this clear, you know, in your mind, that your listening is going to pull your speaking skills up. If your speaking skills are lying on the floor and you want it to go higher, you do nothing. Just listen, listen and listen more. Once you understand this idea, you will improve. Otherwise, I'm telling you, you are going to be disappointed. Very disappointed. So my final advice forever and ever is listening helps you improve your speaking. In front of the mirror. Are those people speaking good English? Those who gave you this advice? What does it say? If I'm not a good cook and I tell you how a recipe can be cooked better, you should not trust me. Simple.
I have a sentence in mind, but I can't deliver.
No. You keep arguing with me like this, and I will keep saying the same thing to you. Your speaking does not help you with your speaking. Your listening helps you with your speaking. If you have a sentence in your mind, but you are not able to say it out loud, okay? If you have a sentence in your mind, but you are not able to say it out loud, okay? Then engage in a conversation with people who speak that language and listen to them talk. Your speaking doesn't matter. Again, I will say, your listening matters. Those people who say that they have a sentence in their mind and they're not able to speak, bring it out, they are proving themselves wrong. You just made this sentence. How come you said this? Apni line kaise keh diya English mein? Jab aapke sentence mein koi dimag mein sentence aur wo muh pe nahi aata, to ye kaise aaya? नहीं नहीं ये कैसे आया, ऐसा कैसे होगा कि एक लाइन आ रहा है एक लाइन नहीं आ रहा? जो नहीं आ रहा ना मुंह पे, उसमें क्लैरिटी नहीं है. उसमें क्या नहीं है? और वो क्लैरिटी कैसे आएगी? सुनने से आएगी, ये याद रखना. तुम्हारे मुंह से वो सेंटेंस हमेशा बाहर आ जाएंगे जिसमें क्लैरिटी है. तुम्हारा दिमाग क्लियर जान रहा, गाइड करना जानता है. तुम्हारे दिमाग को ट्रेन करना है, टंग को नहीं. एंड द टंग विल गाइड योर, यू नो, द माइंड विल गाइड योर टंग. You have to train your mind. Or mind ko kaise train karoge? By listening. Remember that very clearly. So jitne din lagne tumhe is baat ko accept karne mein. But this is the only advice I have for you. I don't have any other advice. Listening is learning. If Vinay Shankar Soni, who was always a Hindi medium student, who never went out of Bihar Sharif to learn English, if I managed to do what I have done with my English, it's all because of one silly thing that I realized very, very late. Listening. When I was a student in class 11th and 12th, I spoke English just like any Bihari. Khichdi has been cooked in my house. Stupid sentences I made because of grammar. Okay. My teacher had taught me grammar and I was a clever boy. Okay. I still do not understand. My Hindi medium students disappoint me all the time. I teach one thing for, I've been teaching this one thing for 15 days and they're still making it, getting it wrong. Where is she? Afreen, where are you, Afreen? Afreen is not here today. Afreen and Shazia? Okay. So what happens? That I was never a dull student. Anybody teaches me that red goes with blue, green goes with yellow, then I will say red goes with blue. Red, blue, red, blue, red, blue, blue, red. Okay, clear. Means I will never now say something else. So when my teacher teaches me, if your sentence has taheti hai, you use V1, V5, I say, all right, taheti hai, V1, V5. Okay, got it. I never got confused with that. But many of my students, I teach them this today, tomorrow, they will start ing in that tahitiya sentence because they somehow they find it difficult to keep that information together in their mind. I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about good students, okay? good students like you, you guys have taken your English to a certain level. Why? Why your English? Why can you speak English? Because you have already listened to some. Your listening exposure or listening experience is bigger than his listening experience. That's why you speak better than him. So if you want to be better than who you are today, you need to bring in more listening experience. Why are you better in English than some other students here? And by the way, I should have said better at English. Why are you better at English than some other students? Because you have more listening experience than them. But if you want to be better than who you are today, then you need to bring in more listening experience. I know it sounds a little boring to believe that, oh, all I have to do is listen. Yes, I know it's very exciting to, you know, participate in a discussion and this and that. But remember, when you're speaking, you're not learning. You are showing what you have learned. For example, if I speak today Bengali or Punjabi right now, okay, I will be able to say as much as I have learned so far. Can I learn something more while speaking? While speaking, I will learn more. No, if you speak and I listen, I will learn more. So learning is a process that takes place in two moments, when we are listening and when we are reading. And this is my job, to help you realize it, that you learn when you are listening and when you're reading, so that outside this class, you do these two activities. You listen and you read, so that you can learn more. And when you learn correctly, then it automatically comes out. Your problem, the problem that you're talking about is that you are unable to say some of the sentences that you have in your mind. Okay, I first of all want to say that every time you have a sentence in your mind, you'll be able to say it. And if you are struggling, it's because the picture is not clear in your mind. You're not sure about which word should go where. Right now, what is stopping me? Nothing. Why? Because I know which word should go where. And when you know that, you also speak. But there are other students who have that kind of issue. Their issue is something else. Their tongue is not used to at all in... Okay, let's understand. Speaking a new language is a physiological thing, exercise. Because, you see, your tongue... You have been speaking Hindi, Urdu words, okay, Maghi words so far. And those words are made with different consonant sounds and vowel sounds put together. When you speak English, now different groups of sounds come together. And your tongue has to glide. And right now, while I'm speaking, my tongue is going in different directions, right, to produce these sounds. Your tongue is not used to it, to creating these sounds in English. So it is a difficult challenge for some people, especially like Rishikesh, Saim, Sahil. It's going to take them a long time to first of all train their mind so that their mind guides their tongue. What is guiding my tongue? How is this coming out of my mouth, all these words? How? My mind is guiding my tongue. Am I telling my mind? Oh, my mind has already been trained, and now my mind is guiding my tongue. So you guys need to train your mind. And how do you train your mind? Tell me, by speaking? Who told you that? Who told you? But when I say speak, I mean to say push yourself a little bit. Push yourself a little bit. It's like taking the challenge. You have learned some English, okay? But then you have a fear inside. Because like I said, learning is just a mental activity. Learning is a... But speaking is a physiological activity. Please understand that. When you're learning, no tongue is getting involved. Only mind. When you're learning, listening, reading, only mind is getting involved. It's an easier job. But when you want to speak, now your mind has to make sentences and your tongue has to go in all those directions, right? If you keep listening for a long period of time, I will say this to you. Suppose you have a child, let's say 5-year-old child. He knows no words of English. He lives in a village, Jemhi Karmhi type language he uses. Now you transport that child from that village to America or London, to the US or to, you know, England somewhere. All right. You transport that child there and you leave that child there. Do you think the first day the child will understand anything that they are saying? Do you think the child will speak any English there? No. But that child lives there for 2 or 3 years. And that child will be speaking American English. What will he do? What will he do there that he cannot do here? Listen to English, which he cannot do when he is living in Bihar Sharif or in the village. So guys, never challenge the most obvious thing. Your learning is a result of your listening. Whatever you know, whatever you're speaking is because of your listening. Rules you can learn by listening to Hindi as well. I can teach everything I teach in Hindi. Sari rules main tumhe bata sakta hu Hindi mein, jitni cheeze padhata hu. Lekin isse tumhare bolne ki kshamta pe zero asar aayega. Samajh bahut sari ho jayegi. Achha English mein aise hota hai. Achha English mein waise hota hai. But it will play zero role in improving your speaking skills. So how will you improve your speaking English? Only by listening. Aur wo main samne se bata raha hu kaise kaise hoga. Ek bacche ko yahan gaon mein rakhne pe kya nahi mil raha tha jo usko wahan America mein rakhne pe milne laga. Batao kya mil raha wahan jo yahan nahi mil raha tha. Sunne ki opportunity. Jo yahan gaon mein usko English sunne ki opportunity. और वो क्या लगता है आपको, वो पहला दिन इंग्लिश बोलेगा कि पहला दिन इंग्लिश सुनेगा, दूसरे दिन इंग्लिश बोलेगा कि दूसरे दिन सुनेगा, तीसरे दिन बोलेगा कि सुनेगा, एक सप्ताह वो सुनेगा कि बोलेगा, सुनेगा फिर उसके मुंह से काक वर्ड निकलेगा, तो बताओ वो सीखा कैसे? अभी भी तुमको डाउट है? अगर वो बच्चा फ्लुएंट इंग्लिश बोलेगा तो वो बोलने की वजह से कि सुनने की वजह से? क्या बात करो, फिर खत्म हो गई कहानी यहीं पर, फिर आर्ग्यूमेंट बचा कहीं से भी? ये आर्गुमेंट करके हम कहीं नहीं जाएंगे. रिमेंबर, यू कांट चैलेंज एक्सपर्ट्स एंड ऑब्वियस थिंग्स. फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम पीपल चैलेंज द अर्थ इज नॉट गोइंग अराउंड द सन, बट दे हैड टू फाइनली एक्सेप्ट इट दैट द अर्थ इज गोइंग अराउंड द सन. सो अनफॉर्चुनेटली स्टुपिडिटी, इट इज इग्नोरेंस ऑफ द पीपल इन्वॉल्व इन दिस फील्ड ऑफ टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग दैट दे डोंट रियलाइज दैट लिसनिंग इज लर्निंग. आप यहां इसलिए नहीं सीखेंगे कि मैं आपको ये सारी चीजें बताऊंगा जो किताब में लिखी हैं. गलत फहमी है आपकी. मैं ये सारी चीजें आपको हिंदी में बता सकता हूं और आप बिल्कुल नहीं सीख के जाएंगे इंग्लिश बोलना. ठीक है, बात समझ में आ रही है आपको? मैं अपने हिंदी मीडियम क्लास को एक शॉर्ट टर्म कोर्स मानता हूं, एक आध डेढ़ महीने के लिए. सिर्फ उन बच्चों को यह दिखाना है कि तुम्हें ऑब्जर्व करने की आदत डालनी. मेरे कुछ स्टूडेंट, मैंने अभी आपको बताया, जैसे मैं अगर आपको बोलूं लाल जाए ब्लू के साथ, लाल जाए ब्लू के साथ, तो आपके दिमाग में हमेशा बैठा रहना चाहिए सर ने कहा लाल जाएगा ब्लू के साथ. तो अगर मैं कहता हूं कि अगर आपके सेंटेंस में ता है ती है रहेगा, करता है करते हैं, तो आपके इंग्लिश वाले सेंटेंस सीधे वर्ब होंगे, लिव या लिव, गो या गोज, बस ऐसे ही होगा. इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं होना उसमें. तो ये बात सुन के एक्सेप्ट करने की और तुरंत फॉलो करने की, अच्छा ठीक है, ठीक है. मेरे दिमाग में चला गया, क्या चला गया भाई, कि अगर मेरे सेंटेंस की एंडिंग होगी करते हैं करते हैं करती है, तो हमारा वर्ब कैसा होगा, लिव या लिव्स, गो या गोज, ईट या ईट्स, बात खत्म, इससे आगे कुछ नहीं. अब मैंने कल बोला हम जा रहे हैं, तो कोई कहता है आई गो, मैंने कहा ये तो मैंने बताया नहीं था, मैंने तो कहा था करते हैं वाले सेंटेंस में होना चाहिए. तो ये है बेवकूफी जिसको आपको रोकना होगा, अपनी बेवकूफी को रोकना होगा. यू हैव टू बी शार्प, शार्प इन अ सेंस कि जो बोला गया है उसको प्रोसेस कर ले और उसको बैठाए रखे अपने दिमाग में. अगर मैंने कहा कि आपके सेंटेंसेस कर रहे हैं वाले होने चाहिए, तब आपको बोलना है इज एम आर और गोइंग लिविंग ईटिंग. अच्छा, कर रहे हैं तो इज एम आर, गोइंग ईटिंग लिविंग, ओके, मतलब हम जा रहे हैं तो आई एम गोइंग, ओके और राइट. तो एक बार अगर ये चला जाए तो कल ये नहीं होना चाहिए आई एम गोइंग का मतलब हम जाते हैं हो जाए, फिर आपके दिमाग में चला जाए तो यहां पर आपकी इंडिविजुअल पर्सनालिटी आएगी पिक्चर में. समझ में आ रही है? क्योंकि अगर आप सारे को अभी के अभी ट्रांसपोर्ट कर दिया जाए अमेरिका, तो ये नहीं है कि आप लोग बराबर समय में सीखोगे सर के साथ, ठीक है, और बराबर सीखोगे एक जैसा, क्योंकि योर पर्सनालिटीज आर डिफरेंट. सम ऑफ यू ऑब्जर्व मोर क्विकली एंड सम ऑफ यू ऑब्जर्व स्लोली. सो योर पर्सनैलिटी विल ऑल्सो प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल हियर. यू गाइज आर अ क्विक ऑब्जर्वर or a slow observer, that will determine a few things. But I want to just make sure that you don't have any false ideas in your mind that is speaking helps you with your speaking English. Sorry, your listening helps you with your speaking. I'm very lucky that I realized it much, much, much earlier and I managed to grow faster and better than many other people who were at my level with me, and today they are far behind because they could not appreciate this, that listening is learning. I spent many hours, countless hours, I will say thousands of hours, listening to the BBC drama, where two people are talking to each other, and I was just using my headphones and listening to their conversation, observing things. And that's the reason that why today I am able to speak such sentences in English. See, this morning when I woke up, you guys will see here. This app that I have. Sorry. I was listening to this morning. Okay, this side. What is this? It was already there. Means I was listening to it. Okay, I didn't open this app. This app was already open, running. I just paused it because I'm teaching. And which audio file I'm listening to? This is called Conversations from a Long Marriage. Now I'm going to play this for you guys for a few minutes here, just to let you know, I'm not giving you advice that I'm not following. I'm doing the same. So I have managed to pull my speaking skills to this level because of this exercise. Okay, BBC for extra. And see, it's on my computer as well, because I know how these things have helped me. This is called Conversations from a Long Marriage.
Too many broken hearts have fallen in the river. Too many lonely souls have drifted out to sea.
Episode 1, She Drives Me Crazy.
The things we do for love.
The things we do for love.
Are you ready to leave, darling?
I need 5 minutes.
What for? Hey, where are you going with that lot?
Just putting out the recycling.
That's not recycling.
You're right.
In India also, husband and wife have conversations. People are the same everywhere. They get angry, they get happy, they love each other, they hate each other. They have similar conversations. The language is different, but the things they talk about are very much the same. So when I listen to these things, it was a challenge initially, no doubt. But today it is no longer a challenge. I just enjoy it and continue to grow, because I don't live in England. I live in Bihar Sri. I don't have the English environment here. Who will speak English to me here? So don't waste your time talking to people. Spend your time and invest your time listening to good English conversation. That will help you more. But I know you will not understand what I'm saying. You will listen to what I'm saying, but you will not understand what I'm saying. Abhi aapki chhamta hi nahi hai observe karne ki. Aur is wajah se aapka sunna bekar ho jata hai, bachcho. Aisa samajh lo ki aapko har ek sawal ka jawab sun ke likhne ki aadat hai. To kitna bhi samay de diya jaye process karne ka, aap kar hi nahi paoge, kyunki aapko aadat kis cheez ki hai? Sun ke likhne ki. Koi bata de aapka jawab, wo likh denge aap. Theek hai? Aur main keh raha hu, aap khud se soch ke jawab batao. So that's a difficult task at the moment. क्योंकि अभी आपको आदत नहीं है कि आप कुछ सुने इंग्लिश में और उससे कुछ सीख लें. वो चीज धीरे धीरे मैं डिवेलप कराऊंगा आपके अंदर, कि कैसे आप एक सेल्फ लर्नर बनोगे. क्या बनोगे? ये क्या होता है? एग्जैक्टली. अभी आप पूरी तरह से डिपेंड करते हो स्पून फीडिंग. एक बच्चा अगर माँ खाना ना खिलाए तो भूखे मर जाएगा. बगल में खाना रखा है. बेबी cannot eat because baby is always spoon fed by his mother or his father, right? So the food is right there, but the baby will not be able to eat on her own, on his own. Similarly, you guys are so dependent on your teachers. The teachers spoon feed everything to you. I'm trying to break free, you know, I'm helping you break free from that habit. That's what this class is all about. So I have realized that some of you guys need to first of all realize what is actually helping you speak English. My wife has no problem speaking English, but her English is at a certain level. It's not going beyond that. And let me tell you, Abhinav, she doesn't have any hesitation. She can speak everything she knows, but how will she add new things to that knowledge that she has? How will she speak better English? By listening to English only. So whatever your skills are at the moment, if you want these speaking skills to get better, spend more time listening to English. And that's the only thing I have to say to all of you guys. Thank you. Now I'll start my lesson. Yes. And if you're still not convinced, by the way, if there are some people who are still not convinced, I can understand why. I understand why you're not convinced. I told you, you don't observe. You're not a self-learner.
We have to pay for it, sir.
You have to?
We have to pay for it. BBC sounds.
No, it's free.
Thank you.
But you don't need that right now, because this will not be a good thing for you guys at your level. What you guys need is the audio files I'm sharing with you, elementary audio files. And then there are YouTube videos where you can go and watch discussions, conversations between people who are both English, native English speakers. If you guys want, I can share more stuff with you guys. But remember, the more you listen, the more you learn. Tutorials? What is tutorials? Okay. Tutorial videos about your work. Got it. Tutorial videos about your work. Yeah, great. Anything. Just remember, you should listen to English words coming into your ears. That makes sense to you. You are interested in computer work. Somebody is interested in cooking. They will watch cookery videos in English on YouTube, and they can also improve their English speaking skills. So what you listen to doesn't matter. Anything that interests you, anything that you are interested. Okay. Yes, unit 2 was almost over. We were in unit 3, actually. We were in unit 3, remember? Guys? Okay, there was some homework in the practice book that we were checking, I think, right? Okay, yeah. All right, yeah. 9 jobs is also easy. Let's do it quickly. Jobs. Look at the pictures and write the job. Find the jobs in the word search. 1. She's a nurse, a beautiful nurse, young nurse. 2. Beautiful and young are both adjectives, guys. I did not say this because I'm a Turkey teacher. No, I said this because I want to help you guys develop, again, some revision for adjectives, what adjectives are. She's a nurse. Nurse is a noun. Nurse is a noun. It's a job. And she's a young nurse. She's a beautiful nurse. Young and beautiful are adjectives. So please develop understanding of what adjectives are, what nouns are. Now, 2. Hairdresser. He is a hairdresser and a very stylish hairdresser. Look at his style. Look at his very stylish beard. Okay. You have this? Who?
Iron Man.
Oh, okay. Iron Man has this style. Okay. All right. 3. He is an accountant. He is an accountant. Middle-aged accountant. Okay. Not very young. And 4, he's a lawyer. He's a lawyer. Okay. 5, he is a taxi driver. Right. He's a taxi driver. And look at this taxi. Okay. Yeah. 6, she is an architect. Or he, I don't know. He or she. What do you guys think? It's a he or it's a she? It's a she. Okay, she's an architect. Number seven. He is a journalist. He is a journalist, right? Journalists are, you know, they do interviews for newspapers, news channels, magazines. Okay, number eight.
He is a pilot.
मैंने बताया ना कि सबकी पर्सनालिटी है, ऑब्जर्व करने की अलग अलग क्षमता है, कोई ज्यादा ऑब्जर्व करता है, कोई कम करता है. अभी तक हम लोग कैसे बोले हैं? शी इज अ नर्स, ही इज अ टैक्सी ड्राइवर. कुछ लोग ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हैं, चार वर्ड आ रहे हैं, राइट? अभी क्या बोलेंगे नंबर एट में? ही इज
अ पायलट.
ही इज अ पायलट. लेकिन आप गलती से क्या बोल दिए जोर से? ही इज पायलट. तो आपका ऑब्जर्वेशन फेल किया. और मैं सिर्फ बताता हूँ, मैं स्पून फीड नहीं करूंगा. मैं नहीं बोलूंगा कि जॉब के पहले ए लगाते, ये स्पून फीडिंग हुआ. बात समझ में आई? आप गौर नहीं कर रहे हो कि स्पून जॉब के पहले ए लगा रहे? नहीं गौर कर रहे आप लगातार? आई सेड दिस और नॉट? शी इज अ नर्स, ही इज अ हेयर ड्रेसर, ही इज एन अकाउंटेंट, ही इज अ लॉयर. सब जगह मैंने ए बोला, एन बोला ना. तो क्या आपके दिमाग को ये ऑब्जर्व नहीं हो रहा कि सब जगह ए एन बोलते हैं? मैं क्यों बोलूं रूल के तौर पर वी यूज ए और एन बिफोर जॉब? मैं क्यों बोलूं ये बात? इसका मतलब आपके कान को वो ए एन सुनाई नहीं दे रहा था, तभी आपको मेरी इस लाइन की जरूरत है. अगर आप वो ए एन सुन रहे हो, व्हाई वुड यू नीड दिस रूल? टेल मी. बात समझ में आई? क्या होती है स्पून फीडिंग? समझ में आई बात? ज्यादातर टीचर्स आपको बताएंगे कि जॉब के पहले ए एन लगाते हैं. मैं क्यों बोलूं? मैं आपसे ऑब्जर्व करने की उम्मीद कर रहा हूँ. आई एम सेइंग शी इज अ नर्स, ही इज अ टैक्सी ड्राइवर, ही इज एन अकाउंटेंट, ही इज ए पायलट. नंबर नाइन. Very good. अभी आप सीखे, अब मैंने आपको स्पून फीड नहीं किया, अब आप सीखे हो ऑब्जर्व करके. सो कंटिन्यू टू ऑब्जर्व. और ये कब करते हो? व्हेन यू आर लिसनिंग. गौर करो, तुम बोल नहीं रहे थे, मैं बोल रहा था और तुम सुन रहे थे. तो यू नोटिस दैट ओके द टीचर इज यूजिंग ए ए. तो आपकी लर्निंग कब होती है? जब आप सुन रहे होते और सुनते समय ध्यान दे रहे होते, देन यू आर लर्निंग. ओके, आई विल प्रूव इट एवरी टाइम, एवरी मिनट. Because it is a fact. Number 10.
She is a receptionist.
She is a receptionist. Okay. And your mom? Well done. Okay. Everyday English. What time is it? Why is here, not here? What time is it? ऐसा क्यों है? ये इज यहाँ क्यों नहीं, इट के बाद क्यों नहीं? बिकॉज इट इज अ क्वेश्चन, एंड इन अ क्वेश्चन बी वर्ब इज बिफोर द वर्ब. कुछ भी बोलना है हाँ, तो फिर वही मैं बोल रहा हूँ. सुनो निगम, मैंने पहले ही बता दिया है कि आप एक ऑब्जर्व नहीं करते, बस बोलते हो. मत बोला करो. कल मैंने एक बच्चे को समझाया, जब तक दिमाग कन्विंस ना हो किसी चीज के लिए, मुंह नहीं खोलना है. ठीक है? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, बोलने की कोई हड़बड़ी नहीं किसी चीज में, ना जवाब देते समय ना इंग्लिश बोलते समय. बी पेशेंट. आधा पका खाना अच्छा टेस्ट लगता है क्या? तो आधा पका वो अब इंग्लिश भी बढ़िया नहीं सुनने में लगेगा. पकने दो उसको दिमाग में अच्छे से, इट विल कम आउट वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. ओके, नो हेस्ट, नो हरी, नो रश, टेक योर टाइम, लेट इंग्लिश कुक प्रॉपरली, यू नो, देन इट विल कम आउट ब्यूटिफुल, इट विल साउंड करेक्ट. एंड इफ यू पुश योरसेल्फ टू मच, too fast, then it will be all half-cooked English. So that will be bad. So I'm asking you, if you remember studying something similar, what time is it? Why are we saying is it? Why are we not saying what time it is? It is the subject. Is the be verb. And be verb comes after the subject in positive sentences, in statements, in questions. Be verb goes before the subject. So that is the answer. Is before it, because it is a question. There is no other answer. That's the explanation. Listen and underline the times you hear. What will you underline? You will underline the times. Which times? There are two times. Which time will you underline? The time that you hear. The time that you hear. Underline that time. Did I send you the audio file? I didn't send you the audio file. Why? Because I want to change this exercise. I want you to tell me what time it is. Tell me, what time is it? 10:30. Very well done. Good. And what time is it? What time is it? No, it is 10:40. It is? So now I'm making this exercise a little more challenging for you. Okay. Number two, what time is it? It's 2:15. Very well done. What time is it? 10:03. Now, what time is it? 2:00. 10:00. Easy, because it's written in words. This is 2:15. In numbers, tell me in numbers. It is 3:15. In numbers.
15.
Absolutely. 3:15. 3:15 is 3:15. And what time is this? 3:15. 2:45. Very well done. Number 5.
8:30.
8:30. Okay. And what time is it?
8:10.
10:08. Yeah, it is
7:08.
10:08. It means 10 minutes. 8:10. It means 8:10. All right. It is 10:02. It is 10:02. 1:50. 10:02. Very well done. And it is 20:02. 1:40. Very well done. How do you say it in other words? 6:30? In other words? 6:30. 6:30 is 6:30. And 6:20 is? 6:20 is? 20 minutes more. If you guys couldn't do it very well, if you didn't answer all the questions, you know very well about yourself, whether you answered all the questions or not, I'll give you another chance. Okay, don't worry. What time is this? 12:30 in numbers?
12 it is.
12:10 means? 12:10. Now, okay, for 5 minutes, I'll give you 5 minutes. Practice alone, okay, in your mind, if you know. If you don't know, and if you have doubts, I'm right here. Talk to me. Don't hesitate. Don't feel shy. I will not judge you if you make mistakes. I'll correct you. I'll help you. I'll guide you. So practice alone in your mind. Okay, you have to say it in a different way. If the numbers are written, say it in words. If words are written, think of it in numbers so that you can build a good connection. Okay, yeah, come on, go ahead, do it in your mind from the beginning, from number one, all the times. Okay, every single time that is written here, try and say it in another way. If 10:30 is written, then think of 10:30. Yes, 10:40. 10:40 or 10:40. Oh, yes. Like this. Okay. And if words are written, 10:02 means 1:50. Yes. Like this. So please do it. I'll give you 5 minutes. And if you feel confused, if you do not know what to say, then talk to me. I'll help you. Trust me, I'll help you. I will not judge you. So what did you realize? The word past is used, P-A-S-T, when there are more minutes than the hour. Okay? It is after 8 o'clock, then we will use past. For example, 10 past 8 is after 8 o'clock. 20 past 8 is after 8 o'clock. Quarter past 8 is after 8 o'clock. And 2 is used before 10 to 8. It is before 8 o'clock. 7:50 before 8 o'clock. So 2 is used to mean before, and past is used to mean after. In American English, they don't use the word 2 and past. They use the word before and after. In American English, they say 10 before 8. 10 before 8 becomes easy, no? 10 before 8 means? 7:50. Obvious it is, okay? And 10 after 8 is? 8:10. So remember, 2 means before and past means after. Ab yahan par se tumhari personality ka test shuru hota hai. Kya bataya maine? 2 matlab? Aur past matlab? Ab bas ye, jab bhi 2 sunna, man mein lana before. Easy. So, ab phir bhi confused hoenge isme. So, it will take time. Different people have different level of intelligence. There is something called IQ, you know. Some people are slow learners, as simple as that. Some people are slow learners that need more time. Don't rush them. Just allow them space. If you expect all animals to run at the same speed, that's not fair, okay? Different animals have different running speed. Human beings do not learn at the same speed. So everybody should be allowed freedom to learn at their speed. Don't force them to learn at somebody else's speed. This creates stress and pressure. Okay, so I've explained 2 means before and past means after. Quarter past 10. Quarter after 10. Easy. 10:15. Quarter to 10, quarter before 10, 9:45. No doubts? Okay. Part 2, listen and complete the conversation. I'll play the audio. Unit 2, exercise 10, part 2.
Unit 2, exercise 10, part 2.
1.
Excuse me, what time is it?
It's about 20 past 5.
2.
Do you have the time, please?
Yes, it's just after 10 o'clock.
3.
What time is it?
It's nearly 2:30.
Okay, I'll play it one more time.
Unit 2, Exercise 10, Part 2.
1.
Excuse me, what time is it?
It's about 5:20.
2.
Do you have the time, please?
Yes, it's just after 10 o'clock.
3.
What time is it?
It's nearly 2:30.
Excuse me, what time is it? About 5:20. 20 after past means after. It's about 5:20. 5:20. Okay, not precisely 5:20. Maybe 5:19, 5:18, or 5:21, or 5:22. Because the word about was used. So about means not exactly. Faizan Ahmed, your mic is very noisy, Faizan. Okay. So it's about 5:20. About word is used when you are not being precise. Precise means exact. What time is it? It's 8:23:36. That is precise, okay? But if I say it is about 25 past 8, it's about
25.
It's nearly half past 8. It's nearly? Okay, nearly is used when you say a few minutes before, okay? Right. So, next, do you have the time, please? Yes, it's just after 10 o'clock. Yes, it's just after 10 o'clock. Just after 10 o'clock means 10:02, 10:03, 10:05, 10:10, something like that, okay? Just after 10 o'clock. Next, what time is it? It's nearly half past two. It's not half past two yet. A few more minutes to go. It's nearly half past two. Okay. Fine. Any problems, anyone? Okay. No problems. All right. Let's move on to exercise three. Write the numbers. Write the times in numbers. What time is it? 10:30. In words? It's half past 10. Half past 10. Past means after. Past means after. Okay. 2. 10 past 3. 10 past 3. Very good. Number 3. It's quarter past 9. It's quarter past 9. 4. Quarter to 2. It's quarter to 2. Number 5.
It's 20 to 6.
22:05. It's
22.
Guys, if you are slowing down, if you are not processing this information fast enough, you need more practice. Okay? You need to look at the clocks more often, ask yourself more often, and then you see, when you are a young child, 9 and 4 is a big task. 9 and 4, my God. 2 and 3 is easy for you, but 9 and 4 is very difficult. But after some time, when you grow up a little bit with more practice, 9, 4, 13 is easy, right? So practice makes things easy for you. So practice a little. If you are, hello Sahil, hello Madhav sir. If you guys need more time to practice, more time to answer, it means you need more practice. Because there's nothing new to learn. Just need to more practice more a little bit. Number 5, it's 20:05 or it's 4:40. 4:40 or 22:05. Number 6.
It's
25:07. Very good. 25:07. Well done. It's nearly half past 7. Very good. Very nice. Okay, I have a question for you guys. What does it mean? Do you have the time? What does it mean? Do you have the time? Iska kya Hindi karenge? Do you have the time? Abhinav, kya hogi iske Hindi? Do you have the time? Very well done, Abhinav. You did not disappoint me at all. Very well done. Everybody, well done, Abhinav. Take a look here. I on purpose did not spend much time here. I want to tell you the same point. You learn while you are reading and while you are listening. That's the time when you improve. Okay? And when you have improved, you show your improvement while speaking or while writing. It is time to show your improvement, that you have improved by writing and by speaking. But the process of improvement takes place when you are listening and when you are reading. Take a look at this sentence, everybody. Do you have the time, please? And the person says, yes. It's just after 10 o'clock. It means the person did not say, aapke paas samay hai. Usne kaha, aapke paas ghadi hai. Samay batayega. Do you have the time, please? So if you stop somebody on the road and say, hey, do you have the time, please? You're saying, please tell me the time. I know a lot of people will translate this sentence as, kya aapke paas samay hai? Lekin nahi, ye nahi hai wo. Do you have the time, please? It means, yeah, tell me the time, please. Okay, it means tell me the time, please. Maine janbujh ke ye sawal aise kyun kara, pehle nahi pata aapko, theek hai? Main ye batana chahta hu ki agar aap gaur se padhoge to aap seekh jaoge, jo ki Abhinav ne gaur se padh liya. उन्होंने क्या किया, he connected the question and the answer and realized, अरे इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि तुम्हारे पास समय है कि नहीं, इसका मतलब है क्या समय हो रहा है बताइए जरा। अच्छा बताओ अभिनव, अगर आप इस पे ध्यान नहीं देंगे, अगर आप ये नहीं पढ़ते, तो आपके पास ये जानकारी होती है अभी? तो सीखा आपने कब? पढ़ते समय। और दूसरा कब सीखेंगे? तो उसमें आप बेहतर होंगे, अभी आप बेहतर हुए थोड़े से, तो ये जो बेहतरी आ रही है ना लिसनिंग वाली और होती है। आई टोल्ड यू रीडिंग विल हेल्प यू ओनली 10%, लिसनिंग विल हेल्प यू अ लॉट मोर बिकॉज you have already done a lot of reading in your school days, yes or no? You had books, but listening, you have done very little listening, and that's why I'm emphasizing on the importance of listening. Listening helps you with your pronunciation, listening helps you with your rhythm, listening helps you with a lot of small grammar rules. You won't realize that grammar rules, for example, when I was teaching you, she's a nurse, he's a taxi driver. And you guys listen carefully. You notice that A, right? And you started using this A. And then you go to another grammar class where the teacher teaches idea, article A, where to use article A. And then they will teach you. Before the names of jobs, we use the article A. और उसको कुछ लड़के रट्टा मारेंगे कि jobs के पहले A लगाते हैं। आपको कि मुझे तो आदत है A बोलने की because of listening. तो वो rules आप सुनते हो नहीं सुनते हो doesn't matter. You are already getting English right. So listening can help you in more ways than you can think. Let's move on to the don't forget section. It is, has, or does. Let's see. Complete the conversation with is, has, or does. My brother is very clever. This apostrophe S means is. My brother is very clever. He a very important job.
He has a very important job.
Okay, have you done your homework, guys? If you have not done this page, then I will not check it now. I'll check it tomorrow. But first, do it. Tasi, have you done it? No? Okay, everybody, do this. I will check this tomorrow. Don't forget section. There is no point in checking the homework when the students have not done it. Now, we were doing exercise unit 3, remember? We learned, now our focus is not on he, she, it so much. We have already studied he, she, it. When the subject is he, she, it, we don't say live, we don't say go, we don't say eat, we say lives, goes, it's, eats, right? So, and in questions, we remove that S. Where does he live? Where does he live, right? Look at these questions. Where do you live? Not does anymore. Where do you live? If you notice, the difference between do and does is of that S. What is the difference between do and does? When we add S to do, it becomes does. If you add S to eat, it becomes eats. If you add S to live, it becomes lives. Take a look. Live. And we add S. Then what does it become? Lives. And if you add S to eat, then what does it become? Eats. And it's easy here, okay, with most verbs. But with some verbs, it's a bit tricky. When you add S to have, it becomes has. And when you add S to do, it becomes yes, dear students. All right. So now compare this, you understand? And now compare this here. Where does he live? You remember this practice? You practice this sentence in the previous unit? Where does he live? But the subject is not he anymore. The subject is you. Then we remove that S. And we say, where do you live? How easy? You don't have to memorize, kiske saath ye karna hota uske saath. Because S is used with he. Where does he live? Does he live? और वो क्वेश्चन में ही के जगह यू, So we remove S and we say, where do you live? Samajh aa raha hai, Rishikesh? All right. Do you like your job? Agar ye bole he, so does he like his job? Does he like his job? But because the subject is not he, the subject is you. So does main se S hatao. Do you like your job? Do you like your job? Do you relax? And the answer will be, yes, I do. Yes, I do. Okay. Do you relax at weekends? Do you relax? Does he relax at weekends? Does he? Right? But because the subject is not he, so we remove S and we say, do you relax at weekends? The answer is, no, I don't. Question number four. Why don't you relax? Why don't you relax at weekends? Because I sing in nightclubs. Okay. Now, imagine, first of all, you complete these questions. Remember, these questions are directly asked of Lisa Parsons. Means you are addressing Lisa Parsons. You're talking to Lisa Parsons. So what will be your first question? Lisa Parsons, how old are you? How old are you? Lisa Parsons, how old are you? Okay. Next question. Lisa, where do you live? Pata hai na, live hai na verb. Verb ki to baat hi hata do. R to aana hi nahi hai isme. Where do you live in New York? Where do you live in New York? Or do you live in New York, Lisa? Do you live in New York? Or where do you live in New York? There are two questions. Do you live in Bihar Sharif? Where do you live in Bihar Sharif? Do you understand? There are two different questions. Do you live in India? Do you live in India? Or where do you live in India? There are two different questions. Okay. Number three.
Where do you work?
Right. Where do you work? Very good. Number four.
What time do you finish work?
Very good. And next.
How many jobs do you have?
Very good. Next.
Do you like your job?
Do you like your jobs? Next.
Yeah.
Why do you like them?
Why do you like them? Very good. And next.
What do you do on Sundays?
What do you do?
On Sundays.
And last.
Do you cook on Sundays?
Do you cook on Sundays? All right. Now, guys, do you remember Lisa Parsons' life story? She's a very interesting woman because she has two jobs. You know her story. She works in a bookstore Monday to Friday. And Saturday, she sings in nightclubs, right? Saturday, she's very tired because she goes to bed in the morning on Saturday, you know. She goes to bed at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning on Saturday. So obviously she doesn't feel very energetic on Sunday and she's tired and that's why she doesn't. Okay, if you remember, if you don't remember her story, then I would say first read her story here. Okay, this is her story here. And then I'm asking you guys to sit with a partner. Two people will work together and there will be another interview today. The one person will be a journalist. He will ask Lisa Parsons questions. And the other person will be Lisa Parsons. And she or he will answer the questions. Are you ready? What time is it? We have plenty of time, right? Everybody, choose your partner. Sit with the partner, okay? Sit with the partner. I'm going to create breakout rooms for you guys. Nausheen, do your best, okay, beta? Do your best. I'm opening the rooms for you guys. Everybody, yes. Help each other, okay? Don't judge your friends. If your friends make mistakes, cooperate with them, help them. And if you need my help, I'm right here. Call me for help. Come on, everybody. Accept the invitation. Come on, start. Who's with who? Okay, he doesn't have a partner. Okay, you can practice with him. All right. And you two can practice with each other. You two are practicing. You two, great, great, great. Yes. Only he needs a partner. Yeah. Zeba, Nair, Shabazz, please join the breakout rooms quickly. Padma Bita, please join the breakout room quickly. And where do you work? Nair, join the breakout room. Your friends are waiting for you. Yes. Don't worry. Just manage with his book for the time being. Padma, are you there? Zeba, are you there? Nausheen and Shahbaz, what are you doing with your mics muted, huh? You're wasting time in the breakout room, Nausheen and Shahbaz? Padma, is your network bad, Padma?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm putting you in a breakout room. Wait there for your partner, okay?
Okay.
Zeba Bita, your network was also bad, I think, right? I'm going to put you in another breakout room with two more people there. Practice with them, okay? Help them, Zeba, okay? I think you understand what you have to do, the interview and all. So I'm putting you with a group, in a group with two people. Rukhsar, room number 7. Okay, okay.
Hello, sir.
Oh, Mehran, your network was bad too.
I don't have.
You don't have what? The book?
Yes, sir.
Why?
I sent
you the book, didn't I?
Yes, yes.
मैंने आपको किताब भेजी थी बेटा मेहरान
नहीं पहुंचा है मेरे पास नहीं है सर
क्यों नहीं बेटा आपको मैंने किताब भेजी तो फिर
अच्छा किसी दूसरे स्टूडेंट को मिल चुका है अरसलान ने कहा
फाइन ऑलराइट फाइन नो प्रॉब्लम्स यू कैन कम एंड कलेक्ट द बुक फ्रॉम मी ओके आर यू हियर इन योर विलेज
नो सर आई एम इन कोलकाता
ओके आई विल सेंड मी द एड्रेस ओके आई विल पोस्ट इट
Okay, sir. Address send me.
All right. You guys are all done with your practice? Okay.
Please send the page.
Yes, it's send me your address, Mehran, okay?
Okay, sir.
My book is lost.
Because the ebook has pages that I don't want the students to have. You know, but I can share, I can remove the pages and send, yes. But the students enjoy having the physical book, you know, to write in. They can get it printed. Yeah. The best. Yes.
Sir, I'm not Sir, getting one... times.
All right. Practice with me now.
Sir,
one question.
Yes, Roshan Bita, what's your question?
Why do you like them job? So, bol sakte hain, sir.
Them job, Bita. Excuse me, Bita. Them is a pronoun. Hello. How many jobs do you have? I have two jobs. Oh, do you like jobs? Oh, yes, I like them. Yes.
Why do you like them, sir? So, bol sakte
hain. Why do you like?
I am always very busy, but I am very happy.
Achha, Hindi mein karte, Roshan. Hindi mein. तुमको तुम्हारे जॉब्स क्यों अच्छे लगते हैं रोशन सॉरी रोशन नहीं लिसा तुम लिसा हो ओके तुम लिसा हो तुम्हें तुम्हारे जॉब्स क्यों अच्छे लगते हैं
हम हमेशा बिजी हाँ, बोलो हमको अच्छा लगता है
तो आप बोलेंगे मुझे बिजी रहना अच्छा लगता है
yes,
वो अलग बात है लेकिन मैंने सवाल पूछा तुम्हें तुम्हारे जॉब्स क्यों अच्छे लगते हैं तुम्हें तुम्हारे जॉब्स क्यों अच्छे लगते हैं Mehran, he's not here, beta. Mehran, send me your address on WhatsApp or Telegram. Not here.
Okay.
Roshan, Lisa. Roshan is Lisa. Lisa, tumhe tumhare jobs kyun pasand hai? Kyun achhe lagte tumhe tumhare jobs? Tumhe tumhara kaam kyun achhe lagte hai?
Kyunki karte to achha lagta hai, bas busy rehna chahte hai, sir.
नहीं तो तुम्हें नहीं ये सही जवाब नहीं तुम टेक्स्ट नहीं पढ़ रहे टेक्स्ट पढ़ो पहले रीड रशियन रीड द टेक्स्ट यू विल फाइंड द आंसर यू आर अ क्लेवर गर्ल जस्ट रीड द टेक्स्ट ओके रीड द टेक्स्ट एवरीबॉडी रीड द टेक्स्ट ओके देन यू विल फाइंड द आंसर
आई लव बुक्स एंड आई लव सिंगिंग
ये आते
आई लव एंड आई लव सिंगिंग
Person loves singing yes, and this person loves books as well. अच्छा बताओ आपको किताबों से हो चिढ़ और आपको दे दिया जाए काम लाइब्रेरी में कितना आपको चिढ़ लगेगा बताओ यार ओके इफ यू हेट कुकिंग ऑलराइट और आपको किचन में काम दे दिया जाए यू विल एंजॉय इट विल यू लाइक योर जॉब सो शी लाइक्स हर जॉब बिकॉज शी लाइक्स बुक्स एंड शी लाइक्स सिंगिंग बोथ शी इज अ वेरी लकी वुमन बिकॉज अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डू नॉट लाइक देयर जॉब्स But she is lucky. She likes her jobs. There are a lot of teachers. They are not happy being teachers. There are a lot of doctors. They are not happy being doctors. There are a lot of engineers. They don't want to be engineers. Right? There are a lot of shopkeepers. They don't want to be shopkeepers. So a lot of people in this world are unhappy because they don't like their jobs. But Lisa Parson is very lucky. She loves her jobs. Both her jobs. Okay. All right. So, shall I play the audio, the real interview? Let's listen to the real interview, okay? Any other question anybody has? Any other doubts? Any other confusions?
Sir, what do you do on Sundays?
Very good. What do you do on Sunday? Very good. Lisa, what do you do on Sunday? Come on, all of you are Lisa. All of you are Lisa. Okay?
Yes. Lisa, what do you do on Sunday? I didn't do so much.
I don't do much. Zyada kuch nahi karte. I don't do much. Because
I'm so tired.
I'm too tired. बोलने से हो जाए correct. ये आप जो confusion अभी किए आपके बोलने से आप ऊपर नीचे हुए ना क्यों ऊपर नीचे हुए यहाँ भी clarity नहीं पहुंची. Once your mind is trained properly, if you know this word refers to this time, that word refers to the other time. The question is why? What do you do on Sundays, Lisa? On Sundays, I don't do much. आगे कुछ बोले? Because
I'm too tired.
Too tired after singing, right? Whole night I sing. आप बातचीत कर रहे हो ना? तो वो खाली जरूरी नहीं जो लिखा वही बोलते हैं. आप कुछ एक्स्ट्रा बोल सकते हैं. I sing the whole night. I sleep at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, so I don't feel very energetic on Sunday. So I don't do much. I just relax on Sundays.
But girls and women all day busy, sir.
आप एकदम आजाद हैं, बिल्कुल आजाद हैं. It's you. You are a Lisa Parsons right now. You say what you want to say. No problems. Okay. Yes. What was the point?
Girls and women all day busy, sir.
देखिये ये महिला जो है हमारी ये रुखसार आपा आप मेरे को खोने मत देना मेरा आपा ओके व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग शी सेइंग गर्ल्स एंड वुमेन ऑलवेज बिजी आप मुझे बताएं आई बिजी बोलते हैं आप आई एम बिजी बोलते हैं तो गर्ल्स बिजी हो सकता है Girls are busy. वो आर छोड़ देती
हैं.
तो ये ध्यान देना होगा और वो कैसे दे पाएंगी जब वो बहुत ज्यादा ऑडियो फाइल सुनेंगी फिर से बताता हूं आप मुझे कभी मत बोलना कि मैंने इतना सुना मेरा नहीं हुआ है प्लीज बात समझो आप मुझे बताओ आपने मीट पकाना है ठीक है आपको नॉर्मली 45 मिनट्स में मीट रेडी हो जाता है आप आज एक घंटे पकाते अभी भी मीट टेंडर नहीं हुआ है टफ है बहुत तो क्या आप पकाना छोड़ के कुछ और करोगे कि पकाते ही जाओगे तो ये मुझे कभी मत देना कि मैंने 6 महीने कर सुन लिए मैंने साल भर सुन लिए मेरा इंप्रूव नहीं हुआ वैसे ही होना किसी किसी का मीट ज्यादा टेंडर नहीं होता टफ होता है ज्यादा समय लगता है पकने में वैसे ही सम पीपल नीड मोर टाइम टू स्पीक इंग्लिश बट द प्रोसेस इज द सेम आज पे रखे रहो उतार के नहीं पका सकते कीप लिसनिंग आज कहोगे सर पागल हो गए एक ही बात पकड़ के सुबह से रटे हुए कीप लिसनिंग बिकॉज आई एम टेलिंग यू ये कोई नहीं बोलेगा तुम्हें ना यही दिक्कत है तुम्हें सारी एडवाइस मिल जाएंगे जैसे मिरर के सामने खड़े होकर बात करो न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ो ठीक है मूवीज देखो इंग्लिश में पीपल विल गिव यू ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एडवाइस नोबडी विल से लिसन टू इंग्लिश क्लोज योर आईज एंड लिसन टू इंग्लिश एंड ट्राई एंड इमेजिन व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन जब आप सुन रहे हो तो इमेजिन करो क्या हो रहा है वहां ये एडवाइस कोई नहीं देगा इसलिए मैं डरता हूं कि मैं जो सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट एडवाइस है वो कोई देगा नहीं तो तुम सही चीज छोड़ के बाकी सब चीज करोगे एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई एम वरीड ओके आई एम सेइंग दिस अगेन एंड अगेन लिसन व्हाट वाज द सेंटेंस बाय द वे What was the point here?
Girls are always busy.
Girls are, and women are always busy. No, that is not true.
Men are always busy.
That's not true, Rukhsar. That's not true for all girls and women. No, there are a lot of girls, you know. It's true for you middle class women. I understand. But there are a lot of women. They are... I don't want to go further because I will be critical. There are a lot of girls and women.
This is true life, huh?
Husbands earn a lot of money. They have domestic help in the kitchen as well. And they just sit and watch TV. They make reels and they waste their time. They do nothing. No contribution to the country. They don't have a job outside. They don't earn money. They sit at home, do kitty parties.
And they go to kitty party. Yes, sir.
They go to kitty parties and they make reels on YouTube and on Instagram, and that's all they do. No creativity, no productivity at all. I don't think that's right, but I have a lot of respect for Rukhsar and Roshin and my wife and Pushi and all these people, because I know these middle-class women, they have a lot to do. They have to do the housework, they have to study, they have to do jobs as well, okay? So I have a lot of respect for you women, but all women are not like that, okay? All women don't have so much to do. There are a lot of lazy women as well, okay? Fine. But Lisa Parson is not lazy. She's busy. She's always busy. Okay, any other question? No, then listen to this conversation, this interview. This is 3.4.
Tape script 3.4. 1. Lisa, why do you like your job? 2. Where do you live in New York?
Sir, we can't.
Tape script 3.3.
Sir,
hi, Lisa.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Now, I hear you often.
Clubs here in New York.
That's right. I love singing.
And how old are you, Lisa?
I'm 24.
And do you live in New York?
Yes, I do. I live downtown, near the river.
And where do you work?
I work in a bookstore, the Strand Bookstore in Manhattan.
What time do you finish work?
Well, I usually finish at 6 o'clock, but sometimes I stay late until 9 or 10 o'clock. But I always finish at 6 on Saturdays because I sing in the evening.
How many jobs do you have?
Just two, the bookstore and singing.
And do you like your jobs?
Oh, yes, I love them both.
Why do you like them?
Because I love singing and I love books. I'm lucky. I love my work.
What do you do on Sundays?
Oh, I don't do much at all. I often eat in a little restaurant near my apartment.
Do you sometimes cook on Sundays?
Never. I'm too tired.
I understand that. Thank you very much for your time, Lisa.
My pleasure.
Okay. So what will you do? You will listen to this audio file. I'm putting it in the group. And don't forget, your homework is don't forget section in the practice book, which I have already put in the group. And two, you have to write the audio script for this. You have to write the audio script for this. And as you guys know that I have done this, I would like to share. Give me a second. I have this attendance. So very quickly, it will take 1 minute only, and I will call the attendance. So what date is today? It is the 8th. 8th, right? Padma is present. Shazia is absent. Rukhsar is present. Faiz is absent because of his accident. Athar Numan was present. And Atif Iqbal was present. Safdar is present. Faizan Ahmed is present. Sahil is present. Faizan Ali is present. Khushbu is present too. Naushin is present. Sharik Ahmed is present. Abhinav is present. Mudassar Alam. It's you, right? Mudassar Alam is present. Ganpat Roy is present. Tawseef is present. Nayar Shaz, not Saad. Okay, Nayar was present. Oh, Faiz Alam. Excuse me? Sayyid Faiz and Faiz. Okay. My mistake here. Arsalan Faiz is present, actually. It is Sayyid Faiz who is absent. Okay. Little confusion I had there. What did I do? Okay.
Excuse me, sir. Shahbaz Khalil. My name is not listed.
I will call your name as well. Rishikesh is present. So is Ayush. Ayush, Sonu Nigam is present. Tam Hussain is present. Saim is present. Mehran Alam is present. Shahbaz Khan is present. Musharraf Imam was present too. Ranjit is absent, Shadab is absent, and Mashuk is absent, Simran is absent, Zeba is present, Roshin is present, and Sweetie is absent. Oh, Lalla and Sweetie in one column, I need to change. Okay, both of them were absent, by the way. Okay, Azu, you are present. Thank you, everybody. It took only 2 minutes, okay? And this is how, Faraz, your name isn't here. Faraz, I'm going to add your name as well. So, guys, we will carry on tomorrow. You have some homework. What is your homework? A little bit of homework in the practice book. Don't forget section and write the audio script. I'll see you guys. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye, sir.
Bye-bye.
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 Take care. Take care.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir. Huh. Yeah. Only AA. Right. Yeah. Otherwise, present, we just keep moving. Empty. Yeah, you're right.
Just fill all of them as
present. Yeah, yeah. It can save a little more time. I agree with you. I'm going to.
Or just many of the students are putting, then just type a P and.
Uh-huh. Right. Lalla was absent. Okay. I'm tomorrow because maybe now. Wait for a second. This was so good because, okay. What is this here? 138. I don't want this. Okay. I'm good. I'm happy with this that we have. Now, do I have to save it? It will be saved automatically. So I can close it. Okay. I closed it. And let me open it again. Attendance. Yeah. Great.
Who can
call register, call attendance later, right, in the class.
And during the class, you don't have to.
But then for that person has to be, no, I'll do it. It will take only 1 minute, like it took 1 minute. It was 5:50 in 8:58 when I started. By 9 o'clock, we were done.
Yes.
Because I know people's names as well. I know who are present. So I won't have to wait for them to say, yes, sir. I can just put P, or like you said, I can just leave it empty and write A when somebody is absent. Exactly. Okay. All right. And I haven't ended the meeting. Oh, I'm still talking. Oh, guys, bye. Sorry, I forgot. I thought I had ended. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.